Now let's go back to our systematic functional testing approach and all the steps in this process. So far we've seen the first step and the second step. Now we're going to look at this step in which once we have identified the values of interest, we derive test case specifications for these values or using these values. And a test case specification defines how the values should be put together when actually testing the system. And test case specification describes how these values should be put together when testing the system. So let me go back one more time to our split program so that we can use the information that we already computed. At this point, what we have is some possible inputs for string, our first parameter, and for size, our second parameter. And we want to put them together to generate a description of what the test case should be. So let me once more rearrange this a little bit. I first remove the description of the subdomains because we won't use them in this step. And I moved up the set of our possible inputs that we're going to combine to create the test case specification. And one possible way of doing that is simply to combine the values for the first parameter and the values for the second parameter, sort of a Cartesian product. So if we do that, what we will obtain is, for example, if we consider the first possible input, size is equal to minus 1, we can combine it with these two possible inputs for string, and we will get size is equal to minus 1, string with length minus 2, or size is equal to minus 1, string with length minus 1. And we'll go back in a second to see what this means. Now, if we consider the second possible value for size is equal to 1, we also have two cases. So the first one in this case will be considering a string with length 0. So the empty string. And we can continue combining this value. But one thing I want to point out is that if we just go in this straightforward and brute force sort of way, we will obtain many combinations that don't make any sense. Like, for example, this combination, which doesn't make any sense because we cannot create a string with length minus 2. Similar for this combination, because by the same token, we cannot create strings with length minus 1. And so there's a lot of cases that we will have to eliminate afterwards. So what we're going to see in a few minutes is a possible way in which we can avoid producing these meaningless cases and at the same time keep under control the number of test cases that we generate. So let's go back for the last time to our steps for systematic functional testing. What we just did was to derive test case specifications from a set of relevant inputs. The following step is to use these test case specifications to generate actual test cases. And this is normally a fairly mechanical step in the sense that we just have to instantiate what is in the test case specification as actual test cases. And it's really dependent on the specific type of partitions and values identified on the specific context. So instead of looking at that here in the abstract, I'm going to show you with an example later on in the lesson.